Hey guys, this is Kate and I'm excited to be bringing you another video in the new year. So I have some new products to show you and I'm just gonna jump right into it and get started. So this is a new collection from American Crafts. It's, I guess, designed by One Canoe Two and it's called Hazelwood. It's really, really cute. I love it. It's very springy. I'll show you what I have. I think there's a lot more papers, but I'll just show you what I have. So this one is called Forest Berry and it has the most adorable strawberries in this nice bluish background. They're just super cute. And then the back is this really cool pattern and it has the full branding strip of another pattern, which I love because I use those like crazy. And I'll show you how I store them. I keep them in one of these like desk drawer containers. And I just stick them in there when I use a paper or when I cut a strip and then don't use it, I just stick them all in here. And so I always have them. Because like I said, I love to use them. So that's the first paper. And then this one is called Lazy Daisy. And it is just this really pretty pattern and it has little words, a splendid, lucky, hello. It has like a watercolored background. It's very like hand drawn looking. I don't know why my lighting is being so weird, but then the opposite side has this really cute branding strip, which I love. And this like mint watercolor background with these teeny little plus signs. I can't see. I'm gonna have to play with my lighting because I think it's really off. I'm sorry about that. This one is called Sweet as Honey. I'm not the biggest fan of this side of the paper, but I really love this side. It's just like a hand watercolor looking black dot, and it has some little strawberries with a white background along the bottom. This one is called Hazel Gingham. Just a really pretty, again, like hand drawn looking big floral with this. It's a mint green, but it's a little more like yellow greeny than it is mint, like pastel. And then like a beautiful hand-drawn gingham. I love this pattern, super love it. And then the branding strip on the bottom. And the last one I have is called Hazelwood and this is kind of the cut apart sheet. It has these nice strips here, then 3x4 cards, 4x6, and then some tags. And then the opposite side is this really pretty like navy leaf pattern. See that? Okay, so then for embellishments, I have the 6x12 stickers and they have gold foiling on them, like gold foil accents. I love the banners down here and the hearts. There's a lot of really usable things. The florals are really pretty. And then there's some nice word strips down here, some labels, arrows, a big tag, and a few words. I think it's a really cute sticker sheet. And there are also some like imaged thickers, which I love because I feel like it's such a good value. I had a little issue with these. There's supposed to be a J here. It's supposed to say jot it down, but the J was missing. I got this stuff from scrapbook.com. I've already contacted them. They're sending a replacement, no big deal. But just check and see maybe if your J is missing. I don't know what happened there, but these are so cute. First of all, what I noticed that's different about these than other like chipboard thickers is how super thin they are. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see how thin they are, but they are so thin, which is nice. They don't add a lot of weight. They're really light and this is just loaded with things. So there's all these really, really cute hearts. There's gold ones, pink ones, patterned ones. There's some little asterisks and then there's a bunch of stars. So there's lots of little embellishments to kind of finish off a layout with. And then there are some big images. There's this big globe, which I love, this giant arrow, this over the moon banner and a big ampersand. And then there's some full on titles. So like Life is Lovely, Lucky in Love, All Good Things. And then there's some kind of like helper words, I guess, you know, like that you could add to another title if you wanted to. So I just think that this is really fun. And if you don't get anything else from the collection, I think this is a really good product and you'll be able to use it with tons of other things because this would coordinate with all kinds of other collections and probably a lot of stuff that you already have. A couple more embellishments. there are some really adorable puppy stickers. They're all floral. It's a pretty big sheet. There's 21 in here. And they're just the cutest puppy stickers. I just think they're so much fun. You can use them on all kinds of things. Again, they're not super thick, which is nice. And then there's small ones and larger ones and just really cute. There are these really fun and different enamel dots. And these are all triangles. I love the colors of these. These are great to stick like in the corner of your photo or stick in the corner like an embellishment. Or use as like directionals, like pointing to something. You get 48 of them. I just really like those. I love the colors. And the last thing I have is the embellishment pack or die cuts. There are 40 in here. This is what they look like. And at the end of the video, I will show these in detail. So if you want to see them, you can watch until the end. And if you just wanted to see a little glimpse, then here is a little overview. Okay. So moving on from this new collection, I have, let me think. The rest of the stuff is like Valentine oriented. So I'm gonna do the stuff I have from the Target Dollar Spot. So I've been seeing tons and tons and tons and tons and tons of videos from the Target Dollar Spot. And with good reason, they have super, super cute things right now. This is not Valentine related, so I'm gonna talk about this first. So the first thing that I have are these adorable cactus paper clips, and you get eight in a pack, which is awesome for a dollar. You can see they're $1. Okay, but the thing is here, I would never use the purple or the red or probably the pink, maybe just the green. So what I did is I took my trusty Krylon pen, which is how I do change anything to gold. It's this Krylon 18 karat leafing pen. I've used it for years. It's how all of my staples in my tiny attacher are gold, and I just run this pen over the staples, and you can see I have a whole bag of them. Like, I keep them intact. I just run the pen over them and then load them into my stapler, and I have gold staples. So all of my staples are changed to gold because that's what I prefer. And so I decided to change these little paper clips to gold. So I just laid them on this little piece of index card, colored over them, let them dry, and then flipped it over and did the same so that it would be, you know, solid. And I'll show you what they look like. And for me, that's much more usable. I know that I will use them like that. Why is my coloring so off? Oh my gosh, I'm sorry. So that's the first thing. And you can get these at like Joanne or Michael's or whatever. They're a little bit expensive, like for a pen, but I mean, I have used this thing for years, like on everything, and it's not even close to running out. So I think it's a good buy, especially if you use a coupon. Okay, so the like Valentine's-y dollar spot stuff. There was a ton of super cute stuff, but I don't need anything. So I just picked up a couple of things. These little 3D heart stickers are just adorable. They're like enamel dots, and you know how much one thing of enamel dots is. And I love that there's white ones and then three different colors of pink and there's three different sizes. Let me open these because how do you even open these? And why are mine dirty? Probably from the dogs. I just want to open them to see the different sizes because there's kind of like this band in the middle and you can't really see. Oh, they're dirty on the inside. That is weird. Okay, and then there's this like thing around them. Good lord, make it difficult to get into stuff here. Okay, so this is what they look like. Really nice for $1. I think they're great, and they're nice and thin. So I think I'll use those. And then I got two doilies, sets of doilies. There's 24 in each of these. They're $1. I use doilies all the time. I use them in my projects. I use them around the house. And a lot of times I'll just color my own white ones, but they're not food safe. So I don't know if these are food safe. I don't think they say. No, they don't say. But there's a phone number that you could call if you want to know. Anyhow, so red and this kind of like blushy pink. It is not a pink that goes with these hearts. So it doesn't really go with the rest of the Valentine stuff that I saw, but nevertheless, very, very cute. And then kind of along the same lines, I got this little cutting board, and it is so adorable. This was $3, And it says, it's like burnished on there. It says love. I got this for two reasons. The main reason I got this is for staging photographs of projects. So I like to have little things like this in the background of my photos, or I'll set a card on top of it for taking pictures. And I have a couple of things like this, and they just make your pictures look that much better. So I think it's a good investment to spend $3 on something like this when it really ups the quality of your photographs, especially if you're on a design team or like trying out for a design team. It seems like they're all wanting like super staged pictures lately. So that's a good little thing to have to help you stage your photos. Okay, one stamp set. This is not necessarily Valentine's Day related, but it could be. This is from Avery L, and it's from 2012. So I don't know. It's called Banner and Wreath. And I don't know if there's a die or anything that goes with it or not. I just thought it was so adorable. And it has all these really cute sayings. I absolutely love the font and the size. It says, happy birthday to you, bride and groom. Happy anniversary. Thank you so much. All my love. Congratulations and heartfelt condolences. Which is really nice to have, even though it's a terrible card to have to make. But I think this is what's throwing off my lighting. There we go. But I think they all fit into this little banner here, which is super fun. And then you have this big circle and some little birds, and then all of these florals. So I just thought that this was a really, really great stamp set, and you can get it at scrapbook.com. I'll put a link below. Okay, then let's move on to Valentine's Day stuff. Okay, I already did a video showing you what I have from the new Crepe Paper Heart Day collection. Let me just grab it so you can see what I'm talking about. It's this really, really adorable collection from Crepe Paper. If I had the 6x6, I would show that to you, but I don't. That's something that I might want to pick up. But the papers are, I mean, just some of my favorite Valentine's Day papers ever. Like, look how cute this is. Oh my gosh. I know I've already shown this to you, but it's so worth having a second look at. I'm trying to find my favorite paper. This is one of my all-time favorite papers, like, ever, I think. And I just super love that. I have a lot of duplicates because there was a little bit of a mix-up. Okay, this one, so adorable. And you could totally use those paper clips with it. So I did pick up two other embellishments that go with this collection. One are these little rubber embellishments. These are so cute. They have words cut out on them, and they're like kind of dimensional. They're pretty thick. I don't know if they're adhesive or not. Let me see. So they come in this little, like, inside here in this little tray, which is really nice. Oh my gosh, they're so cute. No, they're not adhesive. They're just like little, they look like little erasers, pretty much. They are so adorable. You could use those for so many things, like not just scrapbooking. They'd be really cute, like to seal an envelope or something. Oh my gosh. So fun. And then the other thing I got were these fantastical, I know that's not a word, paper clips that are XOXO. I just thought these were so much fun. I'm a little interested to see like how they're going to go on a piece of paper, like how you're gonna like get them, I guess like that. Let's see. Oh my gosh, those are so cute. Look at that. That is so adorable. Oh, I'm so excited. Okay, so that's what I got from the Crepe Paper. I'm sorry, you guys. I have to put these back. I'm a little bit like particular about things. And I have to put them back and put them in this baggie so I don't lose it. And I know, and this goes in my project bin, which I really need to do a scrap room for, but I do have a place where I keep all of my stuff that I need to use for upcoming projects. Okay. Now, lastly, I have two sets of thickers, a few pieces of paper, and one thing of embellishment. So let me show you the papers. These are from all over the place. I mean, they're all from scrapbook.com, but they're like different collections. This one is Pebbles My Funny Valentine. It's called Happy Valentine's Day. It just says Happy Valentine's Day over and over again in a really cute text. And then the background is super cute, just red and white hearts. This one is, wait, maybe they're all from the same collection. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, this one's from Pebbles also. It's called Pretty in Pink. I'm not a huge fan of this floral, but I really liked this side, which is like a pink and red stripe, which I don't have. Sorry. This, oh yeah, they're all from the same collection. I don't know what I was talking about. This one's called XOXO, and it's just a bunch of XOXO. And then I love this heart pattern. Believe it or not, the only Valentine's Day paper I have is some of the from the Crave Papers collection last year. What was it called? This is all the Valentine's Day paper I have right here. Yes, Hello Love. I have some of that left. Some from the paper pad and. Yeah, and then some regular sheets. Some of this is not even Valentine's Day. And then I have a few sheets of this Pebbles collection from last year, which was called Be Mine, like two sheets. And then I just kind of threw in some other papers that I thought looked Valentine's Day-ish, which they're not. This is Studio Calico, and this is Amy Tangerine. So that's all the Valentine's Day paper I have, in addition to what I just got, and of course the new crepe paper collection. So I'm trying not to keep around too much stuff because I do like using the new stuff in my project, so that way it's stuff that's available that everyone can get their hands on. So I've done de-stashes in the past, and I will have one coming up. People always ask me, like, why are you getting rid of such new stuff? And it's because I don't want to get bogged down with too much stuff, and I always want to be working with new stuff. So like I said, so that way it's stuff that you guys can get your hands on. So I try not to keep, if I've already used it and played with it and done videos on it or projects or classes, I try to just, you know, pass it on, get it out of my collection and into somebody else's, because I know that somebody else will use it and I don't want it to just sit here, because, you know, what's the point of that? It's useless just sitting around. Okay, jibber jabber over. I believe that actually these thickers went with the crepe paper collection. They're called Charming. They're so cute. They're black and white. Really, really cute. I'm only trying to get thickers, with the exception of these, and I do have a exception to my rule, that are like black and white or gold or something that's just really simple, because I find that that's what I've been using lately. It's not necessarily what I like the best, because I like all kinds of thickers. It's just what I've been using. So there's no point in having things that I don't think I'm going to use, except for these, which I absolutely love. These are called Ella, and they have little hearts on them. Now, American Crafts did some thickers with hearts on them. I'm gonna show you. I don't know how many years ago, when I very, very, very first started scrapbooking, these were some of the very first thickers that I ever got. Let me find them. It's totally worth showing y'all. Okay, this is Taking It Back old school. These are called Cupid. These are some of the very first thickers. Like I said, they are white with little black or brown hearts on them. I don't even know. Let me see if they have a year on them. No, they don't, but they're so cute. And then I use this one up. So I use it for, it's a really nice size. So I use these for masking like titles and stuff, like when I spray mist titles. They're just great, and I love them. So there was the white version and then this like red version called Cherry. I wish there was a year on these, but I don't see one. They're super old school though, see? Anyways, so my exception is these because it reminds me of how old school these thickers are. You can tell by the packaging how old they are. Anyways, so that is everything. And then, oh no, one more thing. This is the cardstock ephemera for the collection I was just talking about, the Pebbles collection. I can't remember the name of it now. Oh my goodness. Anyhow, there are 40 pieces, and this is what they look like. And if you would like to see them up close, then stick around and I'll show you these, and then I'll also show the ones from Hazelwood. So I'll be right back with those. Okay, so here are the die cuts from the little Valentine's Day Pebbles collection. Now, these have a ton of like words and images and stuff that I don't know that I'll use. I think that'd be really cute, like in my planner or in project life, or I'm probably going to do a Valentine's Day gift for my husband. I've done it before. It's kind of like a countdown thing, to Valentine's Day. And I'll probably use these in that. I just don't, they're not really my style as far as like scrapbooking goes. But like I said, I think that they would be fun in some kind of project. Oh, and then here's some little like to from labels. Those are cute. You can use this for anything. I want to chill with you. That's really cute. I like you and naps. Happy Valentine's Day. There's some little arrows. So there is a nice mix of things in this, but there's a lot of like cutesy things like this. Let's be friends. I'm wild about you. Hey, Valentine, you're cool. Some flowers. I love you from my head to my toes. You're the only, you are officially awesome. I'm stuck on you. I heart you. You've stolen a piece of my heart. You make my heart melt. Just for you, you're my jam, or you're the jam. That's cute. Happy Valentine's Day. There's some lips and a heart. You're extra special. You're absolutely awesome. There's a red heart. I love you very much. This kitten is smitten. And you're a great friend. And then another little heart. So they're really cute. I mean, there's lots there, so you could probably figure out a way to use most of them. I'll try to do a video on whatever kind of project I end up making if I get it done in time to show you before Valentine's Day. Okay, this video is getting super long. Let me move on to the Hazelwood. Anything, honestly. Okay, so there's some leaves and flowers. Lots of leaves and flowers. These are really pretty. I like that they're not, that they're that kind of grayish black. Dear Lizzie has done that grayish black before, and I think Crepe Paper too, and I really like it because sometimes black can be super harsh on projects, and I just find this color to be a little more usable. There's a key. I am not a fan of keys. I don't understand it. What's the key for? They're in all kinds of collections. I don't know what to do with it. Cute strawberry. Here's a gold full heart and a butterfly. And then these are little, like, they're paper clips that you can kind of stick on the edge of a photo or something. I don't really know exactly how they work, but there's, that one says this and that. This one says right now, and this one says today. Here's another strawberry and a gold key. How do you guys use keys? How do you use them in scrapbooking or in projects? I would love to know. Happy home, happy heart, hello world. Some really cute little banners. Am I taking up? Oh, okay. Another strawberry. I love the strawberries. Some butterflies. Some bicycles. I also don't know how to use bicycles. I did one layout one time because I had one picture of a bicycle and I don't know what to do with all the bicycles I have now. Another butterfly. Oh, there's another leaf. I really like those leaves. This says hello. This is really pretty. Bloom. I love the handwriting. And lovely. And then this one says good luck. That would be super cute on a card. Oh, and then there's these really cute little hearts. So there's the gingham one, the gold one, and then the mint colored one. Okay, so that is everything. Thanks guys so much for watching, and I will see you all real soon. Make sure to leave a comment below, subscribe, and thumbs up if you like this video. It really helps me out on YouTube. There's some crazy things going on with YouTube right now, so any thumbs up and comment really helps. Thanks guys, and I will see you all real soon. Bye.